Welcome back to Let's Play Pillars of Eternity Blind. Yes, I'm restarting the numbering. Number 215, now that we're out of White March material. We're gonna go kill an Adra dragon. Or Adra, whatever the hell you say it. Once again, I realize some people may be tuning in just to see stats and how I do it and such. We're all level 16 stuff. Here's Aloth. More or less self-explanatory. Dare. Durance. All the really popular characters, I think. Palagina. And Canna. Couldn't leave him behind. He's was the one who really wanted to explore down here the most. Okay. So anyway, as far as stuff, I couldn't get this working last time. Hopefully it works. I have some of us have Scrolls of Revival, just in case our healers go down. Aloth has Boiling Spray and Maelstrom. Pretty awesome spells. You guys can pause if you want to read the stats on these things. I've had a bunch of those Scrolls of Maelstroms, Scrolls of Maelstrom around, and I don't remember where I found them, but I had at least three of them. Now I have one left. We fought the Alpine Dragon last episode, which was easier than I thought it was going to be. And he's going to take some dragon meat, and he also has Potions of Power, if I remember to take it. I forgot last time. Regen. Oh, you know what? We want to fill that up, if at all possible. He's got one of these scarab figurines as well. Are we out? We have here. Durance has four, it's alright, but whatever. Okay. There's regen. Okay. Climb down carefully. Oh.
Be cautious. Be constant.
I don't know if sneaking is really that much necessary, but you want to be in this area because hopefully the dragon comes between you and whatever enemies, Zoraps and stuff that has hanging around it.
I'm ready. I'm ready.
Hey.
Now, a lot of people just use one tank.
Yes?
Eh?
I?
I'm going to have...
Eh?
Two.
Hey.
Or at least that's the general idea. So you want to take your meat before the scripted thing happens? Palagina.
I'm ready. I'm ready.
Hey.
Okay. Oh, right. We've already talked to it. Right. We left it down here rather than let it free into the world, and we just fled. But now I think I'm not sure if its Zorb friends are still around or not. So we want to draw it as much over here. While not getting too close to our...
I'm ready.
Our friends here. So while that happens... I must be in combat, alright. I can't just take that? I think we used to be able to. What we want is... I don't know if I can use any of this stuff. A fourth level spell called Devotions of the Faithful. Yeah, we can't use outside of combat. Okay, so we'll just let combat start.
Hey.
It's not coming, is it?
Hey.
I'm ready.
Hey.
Facing away from us? Now we're in combat. It's mad now.
Hey.
Oh, she's backlashing automatically. Oh, crap. Well, we got the enemies. Well, I was hoping that wouldn't happen.
Hey.
Yeah, I don't even want to use that.
I'm ready.
Okay. Level 4 spell. Which one are you? It is level 4, okay. Devotions for the Faithful. Sorry, guys. I really want to get rid of those things. We also got... Visage of Consulhot. Okay, so here we can use his Crushing Doom thing. And he's still casting that. Let's see if I get that beetle in. Beetles and spiders. Oh my. Oh, Canna has Hailstorm. Well, that's gonna help. Where's your Hailstorm, buddy? Unfortunately, I don't want to hit Council Heart in the middle of all that. Thing is, I'm not sure why he's facing away. It's so funny. Yeah, go all out. This is, probably, yeah. Definitely want to save the knockdown. Yeah, he's got this thing on the run. Is it attacking? You know, I was thinking about charming this thing. I haven't done it yet. Well, let's try to charm it. Why not? You want first, though? Here. Who's this? Deidas? That's Aeloth? Run up, so you get that too. Okay, so now it's... What is it doing? I don't know what it's doing. In any case, can we reach it to do Puppet Master? Here. Well, that's a Rain Blight. I guess that, yeah. I decided not to. Who has those spiders? See, when I do that iridescent figurine, I get to choose a target. But not with Theodessus. So I don't know what's up with that. Alright, might as well use... Maelstrom. He's had to run all the way up, isn't he? Casting this thing. I can't. She's getting interrupted. Oh, he's terrified. He's still... Now he's dazed and terrified. Alright. Still trying to get this thing off here. Maybe now she can actually do it.
Hmm.
Okay. Oh, finish this thing off. Hobbled. Psychic backlash. Alright, she needs to get focused for this thing, so hit this. We'll do this. This thing is here. Beam of light heals allies and burns enemies gone to fray, so do that. Oh, boiling spray is a... You know what? I haven't used this before. AoE, yeah. It's gonna hurt everybody, so that's not really a good choice. We'll use that. What's it called? Freezing Reek. Oh my god. That was so easy. I thought we were like not even halfway done. Wow. I'm gonna check out the Celebrant Sturge in a second. Not bad at all. A lot easier than the Alpine Dragon, which is what I thought, but... jeez. We spent more time getting ready than actually fighting it. What's that? Peridot? It's all the same, right? Oh, we got awakened Adra there.
How may I help?
What does this thing have? A lot of dragon meat. And an Adra dragon scale. Once full grown, each dragon takes on the traits of the environment it has claimed as its kingdom, and the change is reflected in every aspect of its form. This shimmering scale is of a size to dwarf most shields, making it a worthy trophy. It seems to be entirely composed of Adra, though it bears the same grooves and texture as might be found on a far smaller creature. Yeah, this battle was nothing at level 16. You might as well just run in with no preparation or thought, because... he didn't even have that many people to fight either. Or, you know, underlings, what have you. Okay, what's this say? The violent deaths of two Magranat priests at Evendur Bridge generated grief and outrage at Godhammer Citadel. It did not take long for Maneha to discover that radical red sirens were responsible. Two wizards had placed the curses that killed the priests, but they were backed by dozens of red siren veterans from the Saints' War. As the wizards had no interest in negotiating with Maneha or the Magranites, a battle erupted, much of it running over the same fields that saw combat during the war. In the end, the wizards were killed and the remaining Red Sirens were routed. The priests that had died in the initial attack were buried near the bridge, and the ceremonial gloves of the senior priest were given to Maneha in thanks. We got Celebrant's Gloves, which 10% chance to cast Holy Meditation on a hit. Critical hit, redundant. plus 10% ability area of effect. These were once the gloves of a senior Magranite priest who was killed performing a traditional dirge at Evandur Bridge to commemorate the destruction of St. Widwin. After you helped root out the Red Sirens who were responsible, the remaining priests of Magran gave you his gloves. Oh, goody. Anyway, that's that. I was gonna look around for secrets and stuff.
Nice and quiet.
The Adra is so smooth that you can barely feel the marks of a chisel. Where is your dragon stash? There's a dead person here. The Disappointer. Unique pistol. Terrible. The Disappointer was touted as a powerful, reliable weapon, but it has consistently failed every one of its unfortunate owners. This is a terrible weapon that disappoints anyone who uses it. The gun appears well made at first glance, but closer scrutiny reveals poor design and shoddy craftsmanship. Those who aren't fooled by its appearance still occasionally attempt to use it just to see if maybe the whole thing was made to look this way as an elaborate ruse, hoping that it is an artifact of extreme power crafted by a master who desired to conceal its remarkable nature. It wasn't, and it isn't. Oops. Well, that didn't save him against the beastie. Oh god, it's a giant footsie. The Adra toenail is hard and smooth as a steel tower shield. Giant footsie. I want to see what's back there, but I hate to think maybe I missed something. Just check over here real quick. That's the way back up. Yeah. Alright, let's see what's down this way, which we can never see because the dragon was in the way. Hello? Who goes there? I'm gonna save just in case someone springs out and insta-kills us. Most likely there's nothing back here, but maybe some goodies. What's this? I see gold. Gold enough to sate even a drag. Are those books? I guess he means dragon. Nice. What we got? Ooh. A unique scepter. 1103 copper. What's this? Plus 20% of grazes converted to hits. Crits can inflict prone. It's a superb weapon. Potente med principi, power of princes, was recovered by a Valian adventurer pillaging in Gwythin ruins. When he and his party found themselves beset by a clan of Zoraps, he put his newfound weapon to work, bringing them to their knees with the scepter's powerful attacks. As they fought, his friend noticed and exclaimed, "That has the power of princes! They kneel before you!" And maybe they did for a while. A unique crossbow. An 801 copper. Wendgar. Plus 20% attack speed. Plus 10% of hits converted to crits. Superb weapon. Wendgar. Windspear was once an heirloom in a powerful house that served the first Ferconics and the Mequins of Edir. When the Edirian Empire formed, Wendgar was carried at the head of the unifying army and used to strike down the leaders of opposing forces from a great distance. One of the earliest effective crossbows in one of the earliest effective crossbows, comma, its accuracy shattered the resolve of many would-be resistors. And sticking all this in stash. You bury your arm to the shoulder and you still haven't reached the bottom of the pile. We're filthy rich. This is all in the bottom of our home. Isn't that cool? I want a home like this. So I've got a unique light armor. 501 copper. Vengiata Rugia. Retaliation. Grants retaliation. 6 to 10 pierce damage if someone hits you. Awesome. +10% damage to flank targets. Superb. This superbly crafted set of armor is dyed a dark maroon. The eye is uneven and splotchy, making it look like it was colored by an amateur. In a way, it was. Vengiata Rugia, Red Vengeance, was worn by a young Valian woman who witnessed the murder of her family at the hands of mercenaries serving a powerful duchess. When the authorities questioned her, she pretended that the trauma had erased any memory of the incident. Yet while she feigned shock-induced oblivion, she trained in secret. Since she couldn't wear armor or weapons without attracting attention, she took up work as a seamstress and learned to sew a sturdy garment that would protect her without garnering too much notice. She also refined a stiletto with the hand of an awl, allowing her to carry it without raising suspicion. By the time she began hunting her family's killers, she was quick with her stiletto and inconspicuous in her padded armor. She assassinated them one by one, each time soaking a piece of her garment in the blood of her latest victim. Pretty badass to me. A book! Minoletta's Grimoire. Precisely piercing pursed. Oh, that's pretty sweet. Gaze of the Adragon. Petrified. Oh, cool. Malignant Cloud. There's all the normal missiles and stuff. And a sapphire. And 441 copper. A small shield called Little Savior. +50%. +50 defense while stunned and prone. +5 all defenses. Superb. So +12 shields. Deflection. Little Savior was a nickname given to an Orlin warrior from the Guided Compass tribe who defended Glamfellens and settlers alike during the Broken Stone War. He argued for peace to any who would listen. Few did, and so he reluctantly threw himself into countless battles, stalling aggressors while the defenseless fled. Nothing else. Interesting, you can still select that one, but not none of the others. I haven't really I didn't realize she was even still holding this thing. Okay, so, because I want to compare. Yeah. Think I'm going to be using Little Savior. Unfortunately, I don't have many enchantments available. Now we're plus 15 shield deflection. Cool. Excellent! Okay, so that's it. We're done. Wait, we have one more episode. Or, well, I'm not sure how long it's gonna take if there's a long outro. Next episode, guys, fighting Theos. Again, our third rematch. We'll be finishing the game. I don't think it's gonna be too hard. I think we were fighting him a lot longer than we were fighting the Adra Dragon. The Adra Dragon was like creaming us in like, I think, a minute or less. So thanks for watching. See you next time, and endure. In enduring, grow strong.